Hey everybody, welcome back to Better Computer. My name is Matt. Today we're going to take a look at Things 3 again, but there's a very quick update out today that's really important. That's why I'm making a video about it. And that is an update that adds dynamic type support to the app. So the entire app now supports dynamic type. It's been kind of crazy. This hasn't been there for many years. I know numerous people in my life who literally cannot use Things 3 because they cannot read the text in the app because it's too small for them. And so this is going to allow them to use the app, which I think is great. I'll show you how it works now. It's not wild. It works pretty much how you'd expect, but I'll show you on the Mac and the iPhone how it works. And yeah, let's just jump into it. Okay, first up is the Mac, and this looks pretty much normal right now. If we go into the app settings, though, on the general page, you're going to see a new option for text size. It's going to go to the default, so whatever your system is set to, it'll set the default there, but you can make it smaller if you want. Let me move this over to the side so you can see. This is the default for me. You can make it smaller if you want, or critically for a lot of people, for accessibility reasons, you can make it bigger, so you can make it much more legible. All of the UI has been recreated as vectors instead of just images, so they are going to scale nicely even to these really large sizes. But yeah, you can just basically go into your thing settings and change it to whatever works for you. I kind of like the default, I'm just used to it, but I do kind of like actually blowing it up a little bit, just to get a little chunkier touch targets while I'm using the app. So that's what I'm using for things on my desktop, and let's switch over to the iPhone where it works basically the same. Okay, and here we're looking at it on my iPhone, and it looks, again, pretty much the same. It is a little smaller than normal, and that's because I have my phone set to a smaller type size. So if I actually pull up this and go to text size, you can see it's at 90%. If I make my phone like much bigger, 135, now it's huge, right? And this is gonna be a godsend for people who just have vision issues and need to be able to see a little better, especially on smaller phones. If you use an iPhone mini especially, this is really gonna help you get that text bigger. So I'm gonna go back to my default size. But even if you are at a like a smaller size for most apps, but you think things is still too small, you can go into settings, go into appearance, and then text size is set to automatic, which matches your phone sizing, or you can do custom and you can just blow it up to whatever you'd like, and there you go. Now we have large text, even though the rest of my phone is normal. You have total freedom and it just works how it should. So that is dynamic type in Things on the iPhone. The iPad works just like this as well, and the Mac. So hopefully you like it. I'm so happy it's here. It's a small update, but it's an important one. So I wanted to do a quick video on it. Thanks for watching.